Howdy folks, Doc here with Last Best Tool, and today I've got another tabletop review, or picnic table review, and this time I'm going to take a closer look at these particular snap-on pliers. These are the 908CF, and they're like a small, small-jawed, long reach. And they use snap-on's flattened handle design versus the standard kind of rounded designs you might find on pliers like this, and I think they make a flat one now of in this version. But anyway, this is a smaller plier. It might be long. I'll compare things to this kind of industry standard here of the 196CF, Snap-on's Talon Grip needle nose. So in length, you can see, do it this way, that this plier is actually longer by almost an inch. But it has a much smaller head. So if I line up the pivots, you can see that's quite a bit smaller. In fact, it's about the same size. This is the 95ACF, one of their kind of smaller, medium of the small snap-on needle nose. But it looks like it's pretty much the identical head, except they just got it on a longer set of grips. Now, when you're using something like this, it gives you the small plier dexterity, but with a much longer reach compared to, you know, a heavy duty long plier dexterity. So there's a lot of overlap between these two, but if you've got these two, or if you can see the difference, you know, in your tool using world, if this makes a difference to you, then this will also make a difference to you. And that's why I really like these. This particular one extends, you know, tip to tail almost 9 inches. Probably call it the 9. Silky smooth. It's one of the few snap-on pliers that I got that I really like. Straight out of the box. Most of them, and there's a little bit of resistance. Some of them, there's way too much resistance. But anyway, here's an example of what this thing can do. So I've got a beer can here, and if I lower this, it just easily goes right down into an opening that size and gives me some workable jaws. Whereas if I stick the standard 196CF sized plier in there, it pretty much, you know, gets stuck right away and has no usable jaws. And then, of course, the small one, pretty much the same thing. I can't really expand it unless I pull the pivot out. So this really does give you, you know, some pretty impressive lower grabbing. And that's even more exciting when you know, this is a standard 12-ounce can, this is a 16-ounce can. So if I take these pliers, I'm going to run into exactly the same thing, but these slide right down, and because they're still barely above the bottom, can't do anything till I start opening them. So if I come up to just about the top of this S right here, I can show you what I'm able to do. So notice the spread at this point. And then if I line this up, so you can actually see about where it is, that's how much tip spread I've got that far into the can. So I think they do have a great value. They're a lot lighter. They're a lot more low profile, especially compared to, you know, something like this, and great dexterity. And they, I think, at the tip stiffness are probably about the same, because this is so much more metal out here. But I do think that if you've got to do a lot of twisting, the shorter the jaw, the better. But overall, I really like these, and I highly recommend them if your needs are the same difference as these two. This just takes it up one more notch. So with that, Doc out.